glorify.
Jesus glorified Jesus in our life. Jesus glorified your life. Jesus glorified your life. A mission, a mission, qualified. Jesus qualified.
You would be like a light on a hill. Everybody would see. You'd be a sign and a wonder, and people would see the supernatural nature of God through your life. And as a result, look to the Father and give Him glory. And so I want you to be
Glorify yourself through your life. Glorify yourself, Father.
We break off the shackles of religion. Father God calls us to stand the same foundation. Even though we know, Father, this is primary and forever. Father God, you want us to look beyond to see where we're going, that you want to glorify yourself.
Glorify yourself.
We're always going to be repenting at a deeper level. I want you to be glorified. Let's continue on in John chapter number 17. Jesus said in verse number 3, this is eternal life, that they might know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, the only sent. Jesus prays here in John 17, 2 and 3,
Jesus glorified your son.
To give eternal life to all that the Father had given him. Look at verse number two. Even as you have given him authority over all flesh, get this now, that to all whom you have given him, he may give eternal life. Jesus understood his mission as getting eternal life to those whom the Father had given.
He spoke about this in John 10, and my Father has given me. This is the one he's speaking of.
And notice in verse number 3, he says, this is eternal life, that they might know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. Now notice, Jesus speaking to the Lord. We see into eternity as we look at Jesus' words here in the scripture. Jesus here defines eternal life in terms of knowing God. In other words, the primary definition of eternal life in the Bible is to know God. Salvation is all about relationship. It's not just about going to heaven. It's about relationship.
To everyone that believes, they receive eternal life. Eternal life, beloved, is the gift of knowing God.
So, Father, we ask you right now to bring us fuller and fuller into the dimension of really knowing you. Father, not having a formal religion, we have all this intellectual information and information in our mind. This is the only true there is to know you. Jesus, you pray before you that we would know eternal life. Eternal life, Jesus, know you, Father.
I got the power in the name of Jesus. Nobody can stop me.
We repent for not doing what we need to do. I need to do with my will of God. I want to know you, Jesus.
Cover me against you, Jesus. ours.
And then notice Jesus says in verse 4. He says to the Father, I glorify you on earth. And then he said, having accomplished the work which you have given me to do.
The point
I want to make here is Jesus' last prayer, his long prayer before going to the cross, Jesus said, I glorify you to the Father, having accomplished the work which you have given me to do. The point is that in this high priestly prayer, Jesus is pouring out his love to the Father.
And to the Father.
And I want you to hear that Jesus does not separate loving God from working God. You see, Jesus came to earth because he loved God, and because he loved God, he accomplished the work that the Father did. This means that if we love God, we have to do the work that he gave us to do. Jesus is going to say later on in this chapter, he's going to say, Father, even as you sent me, I send them. What are we sent to do? We're sent to preach the gospel, lay our hands on the sick, beloved, take authority over wicked and demonic spirits and people's life. We're called and sent to bring the kingdom, to extend territory of the kingdom. If we really love God, then we need to do the work of God, because we can't love God without doing the work of God, because we love him, we'll do the work of God. And so Jesus says to him, I have glorified you on earth, having accomplished the work that you have given me to do. And so, beloved ones, even as Jesus loved God by accomplishing the work that the Father gave him to do, so too we need to show our love for God by working for him while on earth to extend the kingdom. We know the Great Commission, Jesus' last words,
I'm on a mission.